I love gospel music, and gospel music has been a part of my life, whether it be the contemporary side of John or the traditional side of John. You know, the rumors about John's in jail, and I dealt with that with a little bit of humor. 10 years ago, I did deal drugs. I was using drugs, and God delivered me. And because of my ministry, the ability to speak right out about the drug issue and our being in the community now, walking the street at night and, you know, ministering to the drug addicts, to the dope heads, you know, God has just opened an avenue for that. So I expected an attack in that area. So I treat it with a smile. We have a project called Project Alternative, where we go into the neighborhoods, the guys in the choir, myself, and what we're gonna do is just tell the guys, say, listen, you know, y'all wanna play us? If we win, you gotta listen to us for 5 minutes. And they laugh, you know, a bunch of old gospel singers coming to the community, and we really whip these guys, and they have to hear the ministry. Our choir rehearsal is just a wonderful experience. And because of, I guess, the album success, people just start coming in our rehearsal. Off the street corner, young people, to be blessed during that hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, maybe four. And I enjoy it so much. At one time, I was going to tell them to stop because we don't get a chance to really practice a rehearsal like I think we should. But they enjoy it so much, and the young people are being freed and delivered in that rehearsal. So I said, thank you, Lord. Maybe it was an avenue to minister to them. So I haven't locked the doors, I haven't closed the doors, and they continue to come every week, from week to week. So we enjoy it. Yeah. Will I ever marry? Of course I will. I think I'm looking for somebody with not only positive ideas, but their own brain. I guess everybody's went through the yes me type of person, and I'm the type of person, I don't need that. I need an innovative person who has the attitude, their own mind, their own career, you know what I'm saying? So basically it won't turn around to another John Key idea or, you know, I think with your own brain, you know, you're interested, you know, so yes, I'm sure I will get married.
Dazzling, my Lord is in the valley, and that's bright as the morning star. That brilliant is in the valley, and it's bright as the morning star.
The choir is not a group of singers, but a group of young people that have been delivered, some right off the street corner. One young lady was a dope dealer, a rap artist, and all kind of, God delivered her in our rehearsal, and now she's doing Christian rap. God can bless and deliver young people, not just to be delivered for that moment that they enjoy the great excitement of coming to Christ, but I teach you can stay delivered. And so the choir is a group of delivered young people that enjoy ministering.
And you wave away all of your past. Yes, you do. So young folk, look, hear me when I say you can wave your troubles away.
Trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not to thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him and he will direct thy paths. I think a lot of times we would just take all of our problems, recognizing that the Bible allows us to know we can cast our cares on him because he really cares for us.
Ladies and gentlemen, the award-winning Prince of Gospel, the Reverend John P. Key, and the New Life Community Choir, all the way live with special guest Miss Denise Tishner and gospel's newest female sensation, Surrender.
Yes, it is.
might as well come out. Everybody. Your neighbor and just say, but I want to love the Lord just a little bit more. More love to thee. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
More love to thee, oh God. More love to thee.
Secular groups. When we would all agree on something in the Coliseum, y'all remember? We used to wave our hand, y'all remember? You know how some of y'all do when you go to a Keith Sweat concert? Amen. We all agree we're gonna love the Lord a little more. I want us to join in and just sing this little praise. Simple, I want to love you. Come on, wait a minute. There it is.
You know, I'm glad to be here today. So y'all might not do it like we do it, but give us a couple of minutes just to give God some praise. 1, 2, 3, come on. Y'all ain't saying that. Wait a minute. Think of his goodness and what he's done for me. He died to deliver John T. Ockett. All right, T. Think of his goodness and what he's done for you. He died to deliver you to you. He said, wait a minute, think of his goodness and what he's done for me. He died to set me free. I did. Right. Wait a minute, think of his goodness and what he's done for you. You ought to come on and praise him too. You can dance. Wait a minute, with your, help me please, help me please, help me please, everybody, we used to hear it. We're moving. Oh, put those hands together, give him some. Come on. Hallelujah. Hey. I'm glad tonight I don't have to be sung up. But when I come to church, I come in here wanting to give God some praise. Y'all ain't saying nothing tonight. I dare you to jump up one time and say hallelujah. Say hey. Hey.
And now, Denise Tishner.
Should I feel discouraged?
Look at your neighbor and just say, I must have Jesus. Brother Lowell Pye from Detroit, Michigan.
Listen,
hey, hey, me, oh,
I'll
yes, I will.
Oh.
Dazzling, my Lord, is in the valley, and that's bright as the morning star. That brilliant is in the valley, and it's bright as the morning star. Somebody found love
way down
in the valley.
Somebody found God.
Oh Lord, it's
in the valley.
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 You don't have to stay there.
In the valley.
In the valley.
In the valley.
David said,
in the valley.
Though I walk,
in the valley.
I won't be there long.
In the valley.
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 Oh,
give up some up and
hit.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh,
yeah. We got to move. Go white.
Yeah.
place in here. Everybody, lift those hands. Come on here. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Come on, say this.
Lord, destroys the old.
The anointing.
The anointing destroys the old.
Wait a minute. God shall praise. Now sit down. Jesus is real. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down.
Jesus is real. I know the Lord.
Comes along and
I've been in gospel music now for about 10 years, and the offers have come. You know, I produced a couple of projects last year where I was in the arena, you know, for the offers to come. And I love the Lord, and my ministry and my attitude is Jesus. And I just can't see John or anybody who has experienced the true knowledge and understanding of what Jesus is all about to turn their heads on him. My family influence started years ago. I'm the 15th of 16 children. My mother sang, my father, singer, guitarist, vassavu. He played in the old E major style. And we grew up listening to quartet, and all the sisters and brothers sang or played some instruments. I attended Marysville School of Music, primarily working with my brothers, Alan Wayne. So the family had a lot of influence on John. And being the baby boy, you know, the light was on you. If you didn't play or sing as a kid, you know, something was up. You know. Got a close-up of these fingers? No. I've heard the rumors that John doesn't really play, and he hires musicians to come in and do the work, and he takes the credit. Being that production is an area of ministry as well, I enjoy producing, and, you know, I'm here at night sometimes in this studio playing late, you know, writing, and God is speaking to me. So I enjoy doing my own production. It's not an area of arrogance or being conceited and not giving others the opportunity, but I know how I want that song presented. So I really play the songs on the albums, I promise. Being a single parent, it's not a headache. I respect my kids. My kids respect me. All of the ripping and running I used to do, as in workshops, always gone. I had to stop all of that. So I don't travel a lot during the week anymore. I'm here for the kids, and then basically on the weekend, you know, if they feel up to it, they go along with me. But it's not a headache, and I enjoy them. You know, being a single parent to some is a headache, but I found it to be a joyous occasion. My street ministry, to me, is just joy. I don't walk in the daytime because the drug addict is normally asleep then. I walk out at night when they're, you know, they're in full bloom. We've gone into clubs, we've gone into crack houses and ministered. And I'm not afraid, I'm not scared, because I believe that God is compelling those that have been delivered to wake up and recognize that they were not delivered to sit on it, but go back into the avenues that God delivered you from and minister. So I love it. The street ministry is, you know, that's my baby. You know, I enjoy it more than just producing. And the music to me is an attention getter to get somebody else, you know, their attitude or their mind. Normally, basically, with an idea, I mean, I'll start, give you a good example, just playing chords. Basically that, and the drum program. Hold on a second. Let's get a little bass happening here. A lot of sequencers, so many people use different ones. For the home, I basically just use a little MMT8. Just because it's real easy and simple to use. Taking a melody or a song. It could be anything. You can give me something. Okay, let's try that. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord.